Bye.
There's three now! According to my calculations, there's too many! They're coming out of nowhere, Sarge!
Dual Captain, I don't have the power!
Yes, you can, son! Charge!
As I'm retreating, man!
Like flies, Sarge!
Hold in there, young man! You're darn right we need help! I need
someone help! Oh, gosh!
It's coming! It's coming! I'm not leaving!
Oh, it's an earthquake! Oh, it'll save us! This can't be good. This cannot be good.
I'm gonna make it!
Oh my gosh!
Big mistake, Captain! Uh-oh! Our tank, sir!
Now this is the destructive force of the 8-ball
This is live! Channel 3, this is live! Channel 7.
I don't believe it!
Did you see that? These guys just shot it on the sky!
I don't believe it! Are you getting
it? Live! Are you on the station! Channel 17,
we're in the chopper right now!
This is a good scene! This is not good! The British Army was just destructed. This is Channel 15. We are reporting live on the scene in Sacramento, California, where a mysterical ball just came out of nowhere across them. This is Channel 26. Reporting live.
Hi, this is the Pat Phillips Show, and I'm Pat Phillips. Our first guest is an Olympic skier. His name is Mark Stouffer. Let's bring him out here. I'm glad you are. Anyway. Doesn't mean he's not a good producer. He might be a little crazy, but still. Okay. Now, sorry, I understand that you were tossed off the Olympics because you took drugs.
No, that wasn't me.
That wasn't you.
No, that was this snowboarder from Canada.
Then who the heck are you?
I'm an Olympic skier, Mark Stouffer.
He's the Olympic skier. He's the Olympian.
Thank you!
Okay. He's the Olympic skier, Mark Stouffer. Have you won any gold medals yet, Mark?
Well, you see.
You know, the bladder's warm. Excuse me.
Well, I almost did, but you see, this guy, messed it up. He, tripped me, okay? You didn't see that. No one saw it. Only I saw it.
Hey, what's that over there? Oh, okay. Anyway, have you won a silver medal?
Well,
stop drinking the water. You're annoying me. Can you talk? Please. You wanna play dumb with me?
No!
Hello! This is the Pat Phillips Show. New episodes every new day. Today we're having a man who is predicting the end of the world come up. Very sophisticated, very, very smart. I think we should bring him out here right now. He's a very intelligent man, and I think his prediction is going to be true.
Just a little superstition I have. First try.
When will that be?
Well, first of all, I gotta tell you, I have been in the psych. I'm psychic. I went to Harvard. I took the psychic course. And don't bother even trying, because you're not going to see it there. It's like underground. Okay, I'm psychic.
He must be
well,
psychic.
Well, you gotta pack your bags, okay? Got your children, all your relatives. I know it sounds crazy, but why don't you just go ahead and find yourself a little shuttle and fly Mars? Because it's going to... Boom! The whole world's going to explode. In about 2 years. Exactly 2 years. Cameron, on me. He's not important right now. I'm important. Okay. It's gonna blow. And it's gonna wipe out all the planets until one away from Mars. I don't know what that planet is. Well, okay. Do you have any questions for me, Mr. Phillips? Because.
Psychic to not scare my audience unless they'll never come back and watch my show. Now, first of all, we don't have the technical advances to fly to Mars.
Yes, we do. Shut up.
Come on.
Okay.
I need
okay.
To change.
Okay. No. I predict. He's gonna hit me. I mean, I'm like so smart.
I predict that too.
I'm so smart. Okay.
Hi, we're back, Pat Phillips, and the psychic is with us also. Want to get a picture of the psychic? Okay, he's daydreaming right now after I knocked him out. Now, our next guest is the son of the devil, or a devil worshiper. His name is Damien. Let's bring him out here. Damien! He worships his father, the devil. One second, will you? This will only take a second. That only took a second. Sorry, but I'm sure you don't mind because he's the son of the devil.
And you should like to know that death is upon us all.
I guess I would like to know that death is upon us all, shouldn't I?
And I will be watching your dead carcasses and you rot in hell.
Swear to God.
God!
Rip out your eyeballs and puke into your dead skull!
Where's God?
I wonder where God is. You're not gonna go to him.
We're all gonna die. Blah, blah, blah.
Smack a chill in your bag.
Shut the camera.
came around. What the heck's your problem? Shut up!
They kind of, you know, like, try to jump me. So, let's bring out my, first guest. Let's bring my guest, Bo 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 Yo! Yeah!
Salted.
Didn't
hurt. Don't worry. Fine. They'll call an ambulance.
Our next guest is the Almighty Mask. Bring him out here. And just like puking your dead skull. You want me to get rid of him? I'll get rid of him.
Get rid of him.
Okay, I'll get rid of him. They didn't make you extinct in the Lost World, but I'm gonna make you extinct on my show! Unfortunate death. So, what didn't you get paid for?
Just about everything. Can you... Falling down? Going around in circles real fast?
Anyway, so can you explain a little bit more?
What?
So you were only in the movie The Mask?
Yes, and Scream. I was the girl that was hanging on the tree.
I thought that was Debbie Moore.
No, that was me.
Oh, okay, not Debbie Moore.
I just had a couple of...
Drew Barrymore.
I had a lot of makeup on, you know. I also walk around New York like that. It's fun.
And you haven't been shot yet?
Yeah, a couple times. Surgery, I shot.
Your
there,
teeth are brilliant.
There,
what
there.
Toothbrush do you use?
There's a drive-by.
You won't reveal!
Yeah.
You know, Mark, why don't you switch spots with the Mask Man?
Yeah, I'm older than you.
This is my cup.
Whatever. Okay, how about we just bring out our next guest?
Yeah, how about you do that?
Yeah, how about that? Come on out! It's Casper! Yeah! I would like to shake your hand.
Oh, this is so good!
Can I shake your hand? Head up his butt.
Sure.
And, this is,
I like you.
This is Casper, who needs a little dry cleaning.
You need to go right on, genius.
So, you guys mainly have all the same story. Am I right? You guys weren't paid your job. And what exactly did you do?
I was in my movie, Casper. And that, I was not paid. That Christina Recchi lady got paid more than I was, and I was the name of the whole movie. So now I'm mad about that.
I guess he has a bone to pick, doesn't he?
I don't have any bones.
He doesn't have any bones. Oh, I should have known that.
I'm already dead.
Maybe we should name the show Wacko Show, because, I mean, we just...
Shut up.
Okay, Jesus. Jesus, please, Jesus.
I want to call Damien back here.
If you'll excuse me, I gotta tell these guys a little something.
Well, it's so hard to face that in this day and age, somebody's race can drink somebody's rage, somebody's preference drives a total stranger. It makes them find some. I feel the way I look in anger. Why don't we put it on for?
Word of God, don't you belong 6 feet under?
Well,
don't you have a happy grave?
I had the opportunity, but I passed it because they told me I could be paid in the movie. But then I didn't pay, now I can't cross over.
These guys are going to meet you pretty soon if they don't stop. Thank you, Bing!
It's a great job. I'm going to get paid now.
I just felt like doing it, you know. I'm pretty pissed off right now.
God, you know,
this is a happy
network. I swear
network.
To God, if I had a gun right now, I would put a bullet.
Happy network.
I'm kidding.
Yeah,
better than I thought. So I'm going to reward them with a nice greeting.
Make sure that doesn't mean beating!
That's what I meant, beating.
Thank you.
I don't have an amusement park.
Better than a stinking company.
Figures in my company. He's just insulting me. You know, I don't like to be insulted. So you know what? I think you need a little sense. Not did you? I know I'm good, yeah. It really ticks me off. Now, before you consult your lawyer anymore about, like, blah, 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 how big approximately is your amusement park?
I'm not sure right now. I am still building on it. It's becoming bigger.
Okay. Our next guest!
What the fuck? Where is it?
That can't be good for us either. Anyway, forget the idea of showing that in class. Anyway, our next guest is a beautiful person. He's a detective. He came from the CIA. His name is Detective Dan. Bring him out here! Answer that question for me. If he's so
I came out of the cloak of darkness before the show.
What the heck are you doing? Are you fending?
Hi. You really are scaring the bejeebies out of me, you know what?
You cannot kill me.
I cannot kill him, can I? I can't kill him, can I? I can't kill you. Listen to me. You short little butthead!
Shut up.
The show's quite boring today, because the lawyer...
Shut up!
Now, let me ask you a few questions. So you do absolutely no... The heck? So you do absolutely nothing?
No.
And the lawyer over here...
is a butthole.
Exactly. And so, you sure you do nothing? You don't end up at any birthday parties, right? Stop meditating, you cheapskate.
No one likes me. I'm very alone. But I like that.
He likes that.
That's the only reason I'm alone.
Boring today. I got a lawyer pointing a gun at me. He probably can't even handle his taxes. You got Detective Dan on the ground. I got him on the ground. And I got this odd Martian dude who says he's got an amusement park. My show is full of bull. Okay? Turn off the camera. Come on. I'm sick of this. Come on. Turn off the camera! Hi! It's the Bad Phillips Show again. It's not new or improved. It's actually worse. Anyway, I've gotten to today will be the best show ever. You want to know why? Because we got Mr. President. Oh, he's not going to come out now. His name is Bill Clinton. I think you should all know that. I think we should bring him out here. Bill! Let's go, Bill! The leader of the U.S. He's the leader of the U.S.
Yes, I am.
So what do you have for, move over a little bit. Can you come closer?
Okay.
So what do you have planned? What do you have exactly planned for a nation?
Well, you know, I have a little speech here. I just want the Americans to know. By the way, I'm in a hair club for men. That's why my hair is a different color. I just want the Americans to know I'm not going to bomb Iraq unless they bomb us. And I feel your pain. Okay.
Of the situation?
Yes, I do.
What do you think of Saddam Hussein?
Well, I believe him to be insane.
Well, let's bring him out here. That's what he thinks of you. Well, let's see what he thinks of you. Yeah! No, say! No one knew he was so short, but he's actually a midget. I brought two really big rivals together. Bang! So what exactly do you think of the U.S., Mr. Saddam?
I do not like them. Excuse me, mister! I disagree with that.
When you disagree with that, I didn't say anything. I don't get why you're disagreeing with us. You're disagreeing. With nothing.
I'm going to talk to you.
I'm just sitting here and you're disagreeing with me.
Now, do you have biological weapons?
Maybe.
Okay, that's it. We're going to bomb you right away. We are sure of that, Americans. Just tell you prepare. I feel your pain.
Come on out, leader of China! Yeah! So, did he just say America sucks?
I protest against that.
Did he just say the U.S. sucks?
I do not protest against it. The U.S.
That really makes me mad. You know, if you're gonna start, you better start using English. I'm gonna give you one last chance. Say something.
It's okay.
You're all gonna be dead.
That hurt.
Okay, you guys, be quiet. I mean, swear to God, I have your dead bodies dragged off.
I'm gonna bomb you.
The rot.
You go there. You are going.
The rivals between, the fights between the enemy are gone. Don't say a word. He's gonna use Chinese on me. Kung Fu. Oh my God. Now you're all gonna be staying out for a long time. Let's bring out the Senator of Texas. Somebody that'll hopefully be just as smart. Let's go! Yeah! Supposed to bring his guns, but I have no idea where they are. Put them under my couch.
Okay, I'm gonna first tell everybody about this. It's called a muzzle shot from the Revolutionary War. Very old, very fine. By the way, I sold guns in all 50 states, and I hope you mentioned that I was a gun salesman. This baby packs a good punch. All these guns pack a good punch. Look at the width of that. It's nice. Secondly, I'm gonna pull out a Cougar Magnum. Well, looks like a little Wild Wild West.
Can you show us all of them?
Wild Wild West. It's a nice one. Very nice. Silver, pure silver. This compact issue of ZC 2000. This is a very good one. Six shooter, and this baby hurts. It's only $75, along with the $15 gun license.
That's great.
Now this, this is a pretty good one. This, as you all know, is a Tommy gun. Got a cartridge in the front, full barrel. This
thankful that
is in most of the wars.